And hold. And release. Well, at least you can manage that. That was by far the worst performance of that piece I have ever had the gross misfortune to have witnessed. A group of demented monkeys could have done better. What makes you think that this is ready to be performed in front of anyone? Another fiasco like that, and I will personally straighten out the lot of you. Again. That was a disaster. A frightful mess. I expect it to be perfect when next time we meet. Lucille, your form was atrocious. Amanda, I think you've forgotten that this is ballet and not some contemporary disgrace. And Alyx, you're an absolute train wreck. Your only saving grace is that you're attractive, and even that is rather questionable. Now, I want you all to go home and don't come back unless you're ready to give me something more than what I saw today. Understood? Dismissed.
Yikes, that was harsh.
No, she was right. I could have given that a little more.
Sure, we all could have, but that doesn't mean...
Yeah, it's just Monica. She, puts us down to try to motivate us, you know?
Yeah, I guess.
And you know, the key thing is to just take it in the spirit that it's intended. No big deal.
Still, is that any consolation? I don't think you're a train wreck.
Oh, thanks, Lucy.
Hey, what are friends for, right?
Yes, darling, I'm here. Hey, Alyx, how are you?
Good.
How was dance?
Good.
No problems? Issues?
Nope.
Oh, that's good.
So, what you been up to?
Me? Oh, nothing much, really. Thanks for asking. Remember that thing I was telling you about with the goldfish and all the crazy people?
Yeah.
I've been trying to work with it all day and nothing is helping. I've tried writing skeletons, character maps, anything to help develop this story. And it's just not happening. I even took a break earlier and went to the store. Yet here I sit, staring at the same blank page I opened up hours ago. I think the problem comes from a lack of inspiration. But what to... Oh, I was talking to Marion earlier when I was at the store, and she was mentioning something about a show at that theater that's downtown. I think we should check it out.
There's a theater downtown?
I know, right? And to think it's been there this whole time, and we've never even stepped foot inside of it. I used to love the theater, too.
Well, then I guess we're going.
Awesome! It'll be fun, and you'll love it, especially being so into dance and all of that.
You think so?
Oh, I know so. All right, let's get ready. Show starts at 7:30, and I want to get something to eat first.
Oh. All right.
Maybe I'll invite your grandparents, too. They have nothing to do this evening, right?
I don't know.
Well, I'll just have to call them. All right, Alyx, let's go. So then they buy the goldfish anyway. You know, it's not that expensive, it'll make the kids happy, etc. So now they have this goldfish. They don't have a clue what to do with it. They take it home, got nowhere to put it. So the daughter runs and grabs this clear flower vase. It's got stuff in it, so she dumps it out into the trash, puts water in it, puts the fish in it, and that's where I'm at so far.
Really?
Really.
You sure there's no more to this story?
That's the thing. There's no way that in itself could be the whole story. I just have no clue how to continue it.
Goldfish dies.
What?
Well, from what you've just described, this is a family of total morons. So they neglect it, or they don't feed it right. The fish dies, they flush it, boo-hoo, everyone moves on.
That's awful.
That's life.
David, please.
What? That's what happens to little fools anyway. It's all very amazing for the first few days, but after a while they lose their appeal. They aren't interesting anymore. And eventually the family forgets that they even exist.
Look, can we talk about something else, please? What would everybody like to eat?
I'll take whatever it is you have over there.
I'll second that order.
And Alyx?
Just a salad.
Well, well, well. Look at little Miss Healthy here shaming us all.
Oh, I know. No wonder you're so skinny if all you eat is salad.
I wish I looked like that when I was her age.
What exactly is the show we're seeing anyway?
You know, I have no clue. I remember talking with Marion about it at the store, but I can't seem to recall what it was called.
Well, what does it say on the tickets?
Tickets?
Brenda, how do you expect to get in without any tickets?
We'll buy them at the door.
But how do we know we're going to be sitting together?
We'll figure it out. Besides, you worry too much.
Worry too much, huh? Brenda, honey, people are supposed to plan for these things. Brenda, you ought to slow down. You eat just like your father. Did you even taste your food?
As a matter of fact, I did, and I enjoyed it very much.
Now, how about you, Alyx?
What was the question?
Are you enjoying your salad?
It's good.
Well, exactly. See, she's smart. She eats slow like her grandmother. You ought to take a few lessons from her on how to eat.
It's not really that big of a deal.
Are you joking? Your mother is an atrocious eater. I think that she
Mother, you're being weird.
Whatever, whatever.
So you already have tickets?
No, we haven't.
Well, I believe we have a few left. How many are there?
There's four of us.
Four. All right, we have four tickets left.
Great.
Well, the truth is, they're not all together.
Oh, we can sit two and two.
Well, it's kind of more like three and one.
Three and one? Mm-hmm. All right, guys, you heard him. They're sitting by themselves.
Well, I would, but he always talks through the show, so I'm going to have to sit next to him so he doesn't disturb anybody else.
Woman, I don't know what you are talking about.
Oh, yes you do. I can't imagine how that you listen to the show and talk at the same time.
Well, what does that have to do with anything?
Well, all right, guys, come on. Alyx? Would you mind sitting by yourself? Someone's got to keep control of these two during the performance.
Yeah, sure.
Great. All right, we'll take them.
All right. There you go. Enjoy the show.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Did you enjoy the show?
Yeah, it was great. You guys were really good.
Oh, well, thank you. That means a lot to us.
You were the one with the big dance solo, right?
Yes, yes, that was me.
Oh, God, that was so good.
Well, thanks.
Oh, seriously, it was my favorite part of the show.
Yeah?
Do all the shows have stuff like that in them?
Oh, well, it kind of depends on the show, you know. Becky likes to fit in what she can when she's choreographing, but she always tries to fit that in a little bit.
God, that sounds so cool.
Yeah, do you dance?
Yeah.
Okay, what kind of...
Ballet mostly, but I do a lot of other things for class.
Oh, so, like, formal stuff then?
Yeah, I guess you could say that.
Okay, did you ever consider doing musical theater?
What do you mean?
Well, we could always use some dancers around here. The only thing is, it's kind of a time commitment.
Yeah, I do dance stuff, like, all the time, so that could be a problem.
Believe me, I get it. I have a lot of friends who do that kind of thing, and they hardly have a life outside of dance class.
Yeah.
Well, I still recommend that you give it some thought. We have a lot of fun putting on these shows, and we'd be glad to have the extra talent on hand. If you can find the time, you should probably audition.
Maybe I will. When are auditions?
I think we're having them next weekend, Sunday and Monday. I think around 7.
Cool, I'll look into it.
Absolutely. I'll be there, and some of my other friends are auditioning too, so I would definitely say that you should at least come check it out.
Oh, well, thanks.
Oh, sure.
Alright, well, I guess I gotta get going, but you guys were great.
Alright, well, I'll see you next weekend then.
You know, I think you will.
See ya.
See ya.
Oh, there she is. She's nice. You're great.
Being so big around.
Okay, maybe I'm being a little dramatic about it. I guess when you look at yourself, you can't really tell how much weight you put on. It'll be interesting though, to see if you can still fit in that costume from last year.
Victoria?
Hmm?
I swear to God, if you don't get away from me, I'm gonna punch you in the throat.
No need to get nasty. Hey, Lucy.
I hope you're all ready to get started. I'd hate to waste anybody's time. Get up! After this, you will do the entire routine by yourself until you get it right.
Oh, that could have gone better.
You're telling me.
And poor Amanda. I mean, she should have known the choreography by now, but still. I wouldn't want that thing thrown at my head again.
No, I don't imagine so.
What do, right? Just try to get better and hope it doesn't happen again? I mean, it's not like we could go anywhere else nearby to do this thing, you know?
Yeah.
Are you here for auditions?
Yes.
All right, step over here. Take a number and a form, fill it out, bring me the paper.
Oh, is that it?
Well, you have to perform, but that's all I need you to do.
Oh, okay.
Hey, you made it!
Oh, yeah.
Well, hey, you should come over there and sit with us. We're all filling out our sheets together.
Oh.
Hey guys, this is our new friend.
Oh, Oh, hey there. I'm Melissa.
Alyx.
Pleasure to meet you, Alyx.
I'm Connor, in case anyone cares.
Of course we care, Connor.
Well, I appreciate that, Eva.
Well, now that we're all acquainted, let's get these forms done.
Maybe I shouldn't do this.
What? Why?
Well, I don't sing.
What do you mean you don't sing?
I just don't sing.
Well, hey, don't worry about it. I don't sing that well either.
Do you know Twinkle Twinkle Little Star?
Yeah.
Well, then don't worry about it. It's really not that tough to get a role around here. I mean, you might not get a lead or anything, but, I mean, they always make space for everyone.
Really?
Oh, yeah. How do you think I get into anything?
It's just so different from ballet.
Well, this isn't ballet. This is theater.
So, did you do it then?
Yeah, I did.
Well, that's awesome! I mean, I don't know much about musical theater, but I'm sure that you'll do great.
Well, thanks for the vote of confidence, Lucy, but I haven't necessarily gotten in yet.
Oh, please, like someone at your level wouldn't be the first pick after an audition.
All right, I'm not that good.
What, are you kidding? You're by far the best dancer in the group.
Oh, come on.
No, you come on. You're Alyx the Great. The rest of us don't have anything on you.
Well, you're really good too.
Not like you are, though. I think they were all a little bit jealous of you.
No. Really?
Absolutely! You're the only one who's got their life figured out at all. Why do you think Victoria and her pack are always on your case?
You think I've got my life figured out? Yeah, right.
What do you mean?
Well, I don't know. Never mind.
Hey, Alyx, is something bothering you?
No, you know, I'm fine. It's been a rough day.
I hear you, but listen, if you ever need to talk...
Thanks, and same to you.
Oh, yeah. Well, you know me. My problems are nothing.
Hey, that's not true.
All right, geez. We can go back and forth like this all day.
You're probably right.
Let's just change the subject.
Fine by me.
Alyx, is that you?
Hey, Mom.
You're just in time, sweetheart. I was just about to put dinner on the table.
All right.
I tried something new tonight. No meat, all veggies. And if I do say so myself, it doesn't look promising. But who knows, it may be the most delicious thing we've ever had.
Maybe.
Well, bon appetit. I was just about to get some water. Would you like some?
No, that's fine. Thank you.
Your report card came in today.
My what?
Your report card from school.
Oh, that was today.
Hmm. Well?
Well, what?
Don't you want to know what you got?
Not really.
You got A's and B's across the board.
Really?
Really? I'm proud of you, honey. Great at ballet, great at school. You're great at everything. There's nothing you can't do.
Well, I'm not that great.
At what?
Anything, I guess.
Oh, stop. You're very talented. That's all there is to it. It's okay to have a little bit of humility, but you don't have to be humble all the time.
I guess you're right.
Well, thanks. You flatter me. Where are you going?
Oh, I'm done.
But you barely touched your vegetables.
Not hungry.
You look worried. Is something on your mind?
What? Oh, no. I'm just a little nervous, I guess.
Nervous? About what?
I tried out for a play the other day.
A play? Really?
Yeah.
Well, give me details. Where'd you audition? At school?
No, it wasn't a school play.
Well, then where was it?
You know that theater we went to the other day?
Oh, yes. Oh, Alyx, that's great.
Well, it's not great yet. Nobody knows who got in.
Well, when do you find out?
Today or tomorrow?
Well, whatever happens, I'll support you. I'm glad you auditioned.
You know, I think I will be too.
Oh, well, how will that interfere with ballet?
You know, honestly, I haven't really thought about it. I mean, there's still a good chance that I won't make it in, so I figured I'll just cross that bridge when I get there.
Oh, I trust you. I know you can manage your own time. And for what it's worth, I think the chances of you getting in aren't as slim as you're making them sound.
Really?
Really.
Thanks, Mom.
Alyx?
Lucy, you're never gonna believe this.
Is something wrong?
Well, I'm not sure yet. Do you remember that show I was telling you about?
The one you auditioned for?
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember it. Why? Did something... No!
Yes.
No, when did you find out?
Just now. I'm gonna be playing a supporting role.
That's great, Alyx!
Is it? I mean, I don't know. Schedule-wise, I'd be able to, but...
Then what's the problem?
I really am concerned about this, Lucy.
Yeah, I can tell.
I mean, this is my first time doing anything like this, and I have a character with a name.
You have a name in our show, too.
I know, but this is different, Lucy. This is theater.
Listen, Alyx, I'm happy for you, really. So what's going on?
What will Monica say when she finds out?
Who said she'd find out?
Oh, come on, Lucy.
All right. Point taken. But when, in all the years that I've known you, has Monica's opinion ever stopped you from doing what you love?
But this isn't ballet, Lucy.
You don't love ballet! You love performing! You love the feeling of being on stage.
Well, yeah.
So don't tell me that it's Monica that's holding you back.
All right, fine. It's not just Monica.
Then what is it?
Well, how will I know if I'm good enough?
Alyx, come on. We've been through this before. You are going to do great. You are so talented, and you're allowed to prove it.
Do you really think so?
Alyx, I know so. This is your chance to branch out and become even better. Take it.
All right, I will. Thanks, Lucy.
Hello.
Well, good evening, Miss I Don't Sing.
Shut up.
Alyx, you killed that audition. There was no way they could not cast you. You earned this part.
Now it's just a matter of living up to everyone's expectations.
Alyx, stop worrying about it. You'll be fine. Do you see the people in this room? It's not like we're exactly the most skilled bunch.
Besides, even if you screw up now, that's what rehearsals are for. You don't have to be perfect every time.
Yeah, you guys are right. It's just, this is such a different mindset than I'm used to.
Look, we understand, and we want to help you feel comfortable here.
Exactly. So do yourself a favor and just relax.
I just don't want to disappoint anyone. This work, my performance, it's all a reflection of me.
You don't expect us to believe that you're not up to the job.
No, I'm capable. I just need to make sure that I prove it.
Alyx, come on, relax. You don't have to prove anything to anyone. You are what you are, and that in itself is something to be proud of.
You guys are so positive. It's crazy. Nice, but a little crazy.
And in one sentence, you've perfectly summed up the community theater experience.
Everyone, listen up! Since it's Victoria's birthday, I've decided to give you a little break today. There's cake on the table. Help yourself. But don't take too much and don't make a mess. If you do, you'll be staying late after rehearsal to clean this studio every night for a month. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Good. Have at it.
Thank you.
This cake is really good, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
You think Monica baked her or she bought it at a store?
Maybe you should ask her.
What? Are you crazy? Doesn't she still have that knife?
What do you think she's gonna do, stab you?
I don't know. I'm not taking my chances.
No, you're right. Monica is crazy enough to stab someone.
She'd probably still make me dance, too. So, Alyx, how's that thing going?
I'm sorry, what?
You know, the thing. We talked about the other.
Oh, that thing. It's pretty cool. It's a lot different from this kind of stuff, but there are some really good people.
That's good to hear.
Yeah. I don't know that I'll be done doing stuff around here anytime soon, but there are some definitely great opportunities.
Well, there's that.
Where are you going?
Save my seat. I'll be right back, okay?
Sure thing.
Hey, Alyx.
What's up?
What do you two want? What do we want? I don't know. What do we want, Ashlyn?
I don't know. You asked me to come over here, remember?
Never mind.
Don't you two have somewhere to be? Like, away from here?
We could say the same thing about you.
Yeah, we totally could.
Yeah? Well, I was here first.
Really? I'm pretty sure we were sitting here earlier.
Yeah, so that means we were here first.
What?
Don't mind us. We don't mind interacting with others.
Yeah, it's not like we're snobs or anything.
Look, I don't know what your deal is, but I'd really appreciate if you would leave me alone.
Leave you alone? Do you not want to associate with us or something?
Seriously, Alyx, what's your deal?
I don't have a deal.
Say, Alyx, why aren't you eating cake like the rest of us?
Yeah, what's that about?
Are you too good for cake, Alyx?
What?
She seems to be acting pretty snobby towards the rest of us.
Yeah, like she thinks she's better than us or something.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
Except, she really isn't. So maybe...
That's enough.
Maybe she's just too fat to eat cake.
Yeah, she's too fat. Because if she ate the cake, then all her clothes won't fit.
Alyx is a little fatty.
Hey, what's going on over there?
Oh, nothing, Miss Monica. Ashlyn and I were just talking to Alyx about the cake.
Well, you two better watch yourself, or we'll be having a little talk with your parents about the cake.
Yes, ma'am.
Alyx? What's wrong? Well, you're sitting here all by yourself, you're not talking to anyone, and you haven't got any cake.
Oh, well, I'm fine. Lucy and I were talking not too long ago. She said she'd be back any second.
Still, I think you'd feel better with a piece of cake.
No, ma'am, I'm fine.
I really think you should eat something. It's unhealthy.
Well, I already ate.
Still, how about I get you a piece of cake?
No, really, I'm fine.
It's right over there on the table. Here, try it.
Well, thank you, but I just don't think that I can eat this right now.
All right, I won't force you. But I'd like you to at least consider it.
What was that all about?
Monica being Monica?
Oh, what did she say?
I don't know, I'm so confused. One minute she's after me to watch my weight, and the next minute she's trying to convince me to eat cake. I guess that's just Monica, though.
Yeah, I guess.
That's horrible. Are you all right?
Who?
Oh,
me? Yeah, sure I am.
It takes a lot more than Nicole and Ashlyn to actually get to me.
Are you sure? Those sounded like some pretty harsh words.
Trust me, I've heard worse.
Still, I can't even imagine putting up with that. Like, just taking it and not cracking.
Well, you get used to it.
What do you mean?
They pick on you a lot?
Well, I mean, I wouldn't say they pick on me in particular, but they do like to start trouble sometimes. You know, every now and then they'll take a jab or two.
What does your instructor say about all this?
Monica? Oh, she doesn't say anything. Not that she wouldn't, she just doesn't know.
She doesn't know?
Well, if she does, she's doing a great job at hiding it.
Why don't you tell her? She may be able to do something about it.
Oh, it's not that big of a deal. I mean, they're not really bothering me that much anyway. Just one more thing to deal with, you know?
Well, all right, but if you need to talk about it, you know Melissa and I are both here for you.
Thanks, guys.
I hate that scene.
How was it out there?
Rough. I think she'll make us run it again, but I don't know. Henry didn't really want to.
Do you know what he wants to do next?
I think he said wind chill.
All right.
See ya.
Alyx.
Oh, hey, what's up?
I think I forgot to tell you I'm having a party at my house this Saturday night since there's no rehearsal and all. Nothing crazy, just a couple friends hanging out. We would really like if you could come. Melissa and Connor are going to be there, so it's not like they're going to be all strangers to you.
Oh, well, that's cool.
You think you're going to come?
You know, I'll see what I can do. I really need to check my schedule, but I'm sure I can make it.
All right, sounds good. I'll see you tomorrow night at rehearsal then.
All right, bye.
What was that? What was that? Get back in your positions and do it again! What are you two doing? Stop messing around and get serious! We're in a very tight schedule here. Now do it again. No, no, no. That is not right at all. Alyx and Donovan, you look ridiculous. If you can't straighten this out, we're going to have an issue. Now do it again. All right. If you can't get it right, we'll keep working on it until you do. The rest of you can work on something else, but you two will be working on these steps over and over until you get it right. Do you understand me?
Yes, ma'am.
You again. Alyx, try not to screw it up this time. Again. 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 Again.
You incompetent! How are you even here? How are either one of you where you are if you can't even do a simple piece? What the hell is wrong with you? You're better than this! I've seen 8-year-olds do this performance better than you did for the last hour. Oh, is this too difficult? Are you incapable of doing a better job with this piece?
I'm sorry, Miss Monica, but...
I'm sorry, who asked you to speak? Did I give you permission to freely interrupt me whenever you please?
No, ma'am, but...
Listen, Donovan, I don't want to hear it right now because, frankly, I don't care. You certainly have your problems, but for once, this is not your fault.
I just wanted to say, ma'am...
Didn't I tell you not to speak? Didn't I?
Yeah, but it's not her fault. You see, my back.
Oh, your back! For heaven's sakes, Donovan, would you give it a rest? Enough complaining about your back. Alyx is good enough to work around it, or at least she used to be.
What?
Oh, come on, Alyx. Anyone with half a brain can see that you're the one that's making this difficult.
But how?
Well, look at you! Look how much weight you've been putting on.
But...
How many times have I lectured you girls about staying in shape? Too many times, if you ask me. This is a perfect example of what happens when you start slacking and don't pay attention to the finer details. If you had paid more attention to your weight, we may not be in this position. But here we are. Bad back or no, Donovan shouldn't have any problem lifting you up. But here we are, time and again, that he's struggling to get you up. Maybe you aren't trying hard enough. Maybe you don't want to be in this program. Maybe you're just too damn fat. Now do it again. And this time, try not to weigh your partner down.
Alyx?
What she did, you're not fat, okay?
Yeah. Sure, whatever.
Alyx, come on, don't let her get to you.
What if that's the problem, Lexi? What if I haven't been letting her get to me enough? What if I am starting to get too slack? What if she's right about me?
Alyx.
I'm not perfect. I mean, it's pretty clear that I'm not perfect. I try, but I just... I'm not up to that level, you know?
Alyx, of course you are.
And all right, so maybe I'm not the ideal weight anymore, but what am I supposed to do about it? I've tried everything. And no matter what I've tried, it's never good enough for her.
Alyx,
I just wish I could be what she wants me to be. I wish I could look perfect for her. I wish I could look like you.
Alyx, don't say.
No, it's true. You're the model of what a dancer should look like. You've got it, the whole nine yards. And all it is just luck of the draw.
Alyx, you don't know what you're...
No, Lucy, I do know. For the first time in my life, I know what I'm talking about. You know I love this life. It's just... It's never gonna work out for me is all.
Alyx, you're talking crazy. And Monica's not the end-all be-all of your career. You're gonna be fine. You just have to take a minute and relax.
Yeah, that's why I'm out here.
Right. Alyx, I have to...
It's fine. You can go. I'll be all right.
Are you sure?
Yeah, no, I'm fine. Thank you, though.
Okay, but you know you can always call me.
Yeah, sure.
All right, then. See you later.
Bye.
Has got to be one of the stupidest things I've ever heard.
What do you mean?
Flying sharks, are you kidding me?
It'd be a really good movie.
Connor, it is 10 o'clock on a Saturday night. At this point, anything would be a good movie. She kind of has a point.
Oh, don't you start with me too.
Hey, I'm just saying.
Well, I'm just saying that I'm gonna go get something to eat. I think Eva said she'd be putting dessert out soon or something.
He is such a geek, that's for sure. Anyway, what's new with you, Alyx?
Not much, really. I'm glad to have a break off dance.
What? I thought you loved dancing.
Well, actual dancing, yes, but rehearsal? That's a whole other story.
More trouble with Victoria and her goons?
No, I mean, don't get me wrong, I love it. It's just not the most healthy atmosphere.
Yeah, I hear ya. For me, quitting dance was one of the best things that could have ever happened to me.
Really?
Absolutely. God, I was miserable. So I quit.
You did?
Well, I figured that I could either let it take control of me, or I could try and get some of that control back for myself. And sure, I miss it sometimes, but that's why I do theater. It's my creative outlet, so to speak.
That's really cool.
It was rough at first, but ultimately, I think I'm in a better place.
Melissa, Alyx.
What is it, Connor?
Do you guys want some cake?
Screw it, why not?
Get us both a piece, would you, Connor?
I'm on it.
So you're gonna try the cake?
Yeah. Yeah, I think so. I mean, who the hell cares what Monica thinks? I'm my own person. I can be as slack as I want. Who the hell is she to tell me what I have to look like, or this, or that, or the other thing? I mean, who the hell is she, right?
Good for you.
Savor this, my friends, because that cake is almost gone.
Well, lucky for us, we have someone to bring us our food.
Oh, lucky indeed.
I gotta go to I'll be back.
Hey, no worries.
We aren't going anywhere.
Sweetheart, could you take a look at these for me and let me know what you think?
What?
I've been agonizing over this last chapter for over an hour, and I think it's pretty good, but I'd like a second set of eyes, so would you mind just looking it over for me?
Oh, yeah, sure. I thought he was 12.
I'm sorry?
The boy. I thought he was 12.
He is.
This whole thing takes place on his 11th birthday.
What? Crap, you're right. Now I've gotta... Thanks, Alyx. Can't believe I overlooked something as big as that.
No problem.
So here we are, Tech Week.
5 straight days of nonstop fun.
Mm-hmm. So the show's this Friday, huh?
Yep, and then we have our 3 weekend run, and then it's on to the next one.
Speaking of which, are you going to be auditioning for the next one?
Yes. This has been such a great experience for me. I'm actually thinking about asking my friend from ballet to come and join us.
Really? That'd be so cool.
Yeah, like I said, we could always use more dancers.
God, she really is very talented. She's really modest about herself, but she's very good.
We could definitely use some modesty around here for once.
But, in all seriousness, I really want to thank you guys. I don't know what I would have done without your support.
Hey, that's what friends are for, Alyx. We bring each other up. When somebody gets down, we just bring them up again.
You know, it's really great to get away from the competitiveness of ballet. It reminds you that not everyone is out to get you for once.
Although, if you ask me, there is enough one-upmanship at this theater to go around.
All right, it looks like the next number is starting. I'd better get out of here.
What about your cake?
It was too much for me to eat anyway. If one of you guys wants it, you're more than welcome to have it.
You should try it. Eva's mom makes some really good cake.
Well, are you sure you're the one who asked about it?
No, I already ate. I just like to mess with her sometimes.
You guys are crazy.
Still, I thought you'd be hanging out with us long enough by now.
Got another production under our belts.
Wow, you're right. How many is I making now?
I don't know, a lot. You know, I can't remember a time that we weren't dancing together.
You can say that again.
Lucy, you know I've had kind of a rough time. And you've had some ups and downs, too.
That's for sure.
But we've always stuck it through.
Yeah, we have.
Lucy, I'm coming out on the other side of something. Something that's been eating away at me for years. You know, a few days ago, I couldn't tell you when the last time I had something to eat that wasn't a salad or some kind of low-carb vegetable dish. But now, things have changed for me. I feel comfortable with myself again.
And why is that?
Well, that's what I wanted to talk to you about. In a few days, the theater will be having auditions.
Uh-huh.
And I think you should try out.
What?
It'll be fun, you know, show off your skills, meet new people. It's a performer's dream.
Alyx, I don't think so.
Lucy, come on. You've gotta. Getting involved in theater has changed my life in so many ways. It's an amazing opportunity.
Alyx, listen, I don't know. I mean, I appreciate the offer, but ballet's the only thing I know. It's my whole life. I just don't think I'd cut it at the theater.
Are you kidding me? Sure, it isn't ballet, but that isn't necessarily a bad thing. One of the biggest differences that I've noticed is that people are so much more accepting here. They're all nice and helpful, and think about it. No more Ashlands or Nicoles or Victorias pestering you, telling you who to be. You can just be yourself.
But I wouldn't fit in.
Fit in? Lucy, no one fits in. It's theater. There are all kinds of people from all kinds of different backgrounds. It really is a community theater. It's not just for pretty girls with long legs. It's for everyone.
It sounds nice.
It is.
But what will my mother say? To her, ballet is everything. Since I was little, that's all she'd want from me is become a professional dancer. She'd take me to shows and performances and all kinds of things. And she'd say, look, that's gonna be you up there. She's got all these plans for my dreams and my future, and somehow I don't think becoming an actress is one of them.
Lucy, you can't let other people control you. It doesn't end well. I learned the hard way.
But Alyx, she's my mother.
All right. All right, I understand. I just thought it would be a good thing, you know?
Yeah, I know.
All this time, you've been supporting me, and I think it's high time that I support you on something.
Alyx.
So, what do you say? You don't have to be in the show. Just come to the audition. Just be there.
All right, I'll come.
You will?
Yes, I'll come.
That's great. I promise you're not going to regret anything.
I better not. I've gone through all this trouble to convince my mom for nothing.
Alyx, what's wrong?
Nothing. It's just Lucy should have been here a half an hour ago.
Well, maybe she got stuck in traffic.
Or maybe her mom didn't let her come.
Well, maybe, but I would like to think she would have texted me by now.
Well, I mean, she's still got like 10 minutes. Maybe she'll show up.
I hope so.
Where's your friend, Alyx?
I don't know. I've texted her like a million times and she won't respond.
Well, I'm sorry, but we're gonna have to start the audition. I can hold for about 5 minutes, but after that it's a little late.
Yes, ma'am. I understand.
All right.
Alyx! What happened?
I don't know. Lucy just never showed up.
Do you think she's all right?
I'm not sure. She isn't responding to any of my messages.
Well, I'm sorry, Alyx. Maybe she'll make the next one.
Yeah.
So what are you going to do now?
I don't know.
Well, I invited Melissa and Connor over if you want to come hang out.
You know, I'd love to, but I need to check up on something first.
Yeah, sure, no problem. Just let us know when you're planning to swing by.
All right. Sure thing, Eva. Thanks.
Don't mention it. See you later.
All right.
Miss Penn?
Alyx, what are you doing out there?
I just came to ask if Lucy was home.
If I recall, she was going to an audition with you.
Well, that was the plan, but she never showed up.
That's odd. But come to think of it, I never heard her leave. But I called upstairs and she didn't answer, so I just assumed she had.
May I come in?
Oh, of course, dear.
If Lucy were still in the house, where do you think she would be?
I'm not sure. Somewhere upstairs, probably.
Well, if you don't mind, I'd like to talk to her.
Oh, believe me, I would like to as well. Lucy! Lucy! Lucille Elizabeth Penn, what are you doing up there?
Should we?
Come on upstairs, Alyx. And if you could, just make sure she isn't in the restroom.
All right. Miss Penn?
What is it, darling?
I think I found her.
Oh, wonderful. What is she?
So there you have it, Lucille Elizabeth Penn, dead at 17, an amazingly talented dancer who had a whole future ahead of her. She had already gone when the EMTs arrived at the scene. Cardiac arrest, they said. A heart attack. Doctors said that it was probably caused by the immense strain that her body was under. What immense strain? Lucy was a bulimic. She would go around laughing, smiling, having a good time, and then would run to the bathroom to vomit up her last meal. Doing it regularly put her body through hell. Eventually, her heart just quit on her. From what I understand, Lucy had every intention of coming to that audition, but when she went upstairs to ditch that night's dinner, her body had decided that enough was enough. Having struggled with anorexia for years, I know firsthand what kind of downward spiral having an eating disorder can throw you into. But like Lucy, we all try to hide our shortcomings. We'd rather die than let someone help us. Very few people who suffer from eating disorders make it out on the other side. Most of them either die from it or kill themselves because of it. These are people who forfeit their future for gratification in the present. We all want the perfect body, that supermodel look that is constantly advertised to us by television and magazines, and even our own friends and mentors. The pressure to be perfect is overwhelming to the point that we believe that achieving that will make us happy. But that couldn't be farther from the truth. There is no way to fulfill the dream of becoming perfect, and it tears us up inside. We can't achieve the impossible, and we hate ourselves for it. It's a waking nightmare that few can escape. I was fortunate enough to be given that second chance. And now I want to tell everyone that while eating disorders are very difficult to recover from, they're very easy to prevent. No one should ever have to turn to starvation or binging to make themselves feel better. No one should be ashamed to talk about what's bothering them. The only way to prevent yourself from going through what I did or falling into the same snare that took Lucy is to communicate. This is a real problem, and it needs to be discussed. For a long time, I hated myself. No one should have to go through that. Ever. Thank you.